The big reason why I got you on this call is there's something that I'm hearing all the time. People ask me this question all the time. So I figured let's address it. Let's jump into it. And it'll be awesome for people to see, you know. So it's a couple of things that people want to know. So if you don't mind, I'm going to throw it at you. Maybe you can share your screen, show us some actual examples. And let's freaking dive into it, man. So I hope you're ready, man. So the first one that I'm getting all the time is people ask me, what is a confused market? So that's the first one we get. So maybe you can show us.
At MPSH, we don't really like confused markets. We want, I want to say easy sales. So if someone goes into a market, we want our product there and they should easily know this is what they want. They shouldn't be confronted with multiple different offerings, etc. So we kind of want it easy for them to just kind of see our product and click into it. So I'm going to show a couple of confused markets here. So this is an example that we get often.
Oh, yeah.
It's a burger press.
Oh, yeah.
Obviously, we always look at the search results, and having a low amount of search results is a very good thing. But in this case, obviously, if I scroll down, you're going to see a lot of different types of images. You have this one. This one looks a bit different, has a little bit of a swivel. This is also a burger press, and it's like two pieces. This is a single piece. This one's rectangular. If I go in here, like if I want to buy you a burger press, Rupert, I will not know what to buy. It's going to be very difficult for me to make a choice. I'm going to come into this market, look in here, and I'm going to be like, I need to phone you and figure out what you want. So I'm not going to be able to buy this for you easily. Another example would be, let's go look at something like a calf stretcher.
And while you search for a calf stretcher, exactly that, man. So you've got all the different sizes, different shapes there. Oh, yeah. Okay. Wow. This is
interesting. Yeah, so again, the search results are rather low. So we want to see anything below 1,000 is we're happy with. And on the first line, it looks decent, I guess, because these three are the same. And you might think there's only three different types. Now, we usually ignore the sponsored products anyway, because they just repeat somewhere else in the market. So on this line, it looks okay. It looks like there's only like three types. And then suddenly, okay, if I scroll down a bit, then suddenly I'm confronted with that type. Okay, there's a wooden one. There's like a strap, you know, and it just becomes very confusing. I don't like, as the consumer, I'm going to have to click into every listing and figure out what is the benefits of each one. And it's going to take me a long time to figure out what I want to buy. And I don't want that. I want someone seeing my product thinking, yeah, that's what I want. Click, click. And then ding dong, delivered to your house. So this is something that I'd probably stay away from. I have another last one. If you look at anything silicone, let's go silicone, silicon baking cups. I like this one. I want to buy you a silicon baking cup. I'm going to be confronted with, well, again, low level of search results, which is very good. Ignoring the sponsored products again, but I'm going in here. And then I'm seeing, okay, the price points are all over the place. There's like bigger, different pack sizes, different shapes, $4.99, $10.99. But it's rather confusing to come in here and see what you want to buy, because there's just too many options. So I'll just show the opposite. Something that's not really a confusing market would be something like a flagpole hitch. Low level of search results. That's what it looks like. there's not really a lot of types. Maybe you can go like, oh, do I want one or two? Yeah. But that's basically it. If I look here, I mean, that's just what it looks like. It's easy. I mean, if I want to buy one, it's going to look like that. And yeah, it's not confusing. And if I come in here with, you know, a good price, I mean, I can compete here. It's not going to be very confusing for anyone to kind of sell this kind of product.
So it's almost like you're asking yourself, like, how can I stand out in the market? In this, I can stand out because everything's the same. I can add a couple of things there, like a bonus. So how can I stand out? Is that correct? Is that something you ask?
Yeah, look, you wanna, I mean, if we look at this first line and everyone's selling this and someone is selling this with something extra, it's gonna pop up there and people are like, wow, that's value. And the idea is to provide value to our customers. That's the aim of the game. It's not just, we don't want to just put something in there just for the sake of putting something in there. We want to look at the market and say, look, this is what everyone is doing. We want to add value. And then we want to stand out by being more valuable than the competition.
So, dude, I love that. That's a couple examples there on what's confused and what's not confused. So anyone that's watching this video, in the comments, give me a no confusion in the comments, right? Let me go and see that. So the second thing, Mian, like if I can put you on the spot here again, that I get all the time is, okay, now I understand what's confused, but what is cloned? What is a cloned market? How does that look like?
Yeah, so if I want to look at a cloned market, I have one here. It's called a cost net. If I see the market, I see there's still a low level of search results, which I'm happy with. These first sponsored ones, I'm still ignoring. But when I go into the market, I see, okay, well, those two going down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, everyone's looking the same. All of these products are just the same. I mean, this is a very, very cloned market. For me to come in here, I mean, what image will I put in that people are going to go and look at my product? So this is something I would like to stay away from. Even sometimes you get a cloned market that looks, I would say, almost clean in a sense that all the images look like this and people think, well, what if I just put a little bonus item, then I'm going to stand out? It doesn't really work like that. We've seen that if you go into a cloned market, for you to get onto the first page and actually get your product visible in a cloned market, it's just me too. It's not really valuable for people. Yeah, you won't really get that amount of sessions or sales that you're looking for.
That was a question I was going to ask you. People ask me, okay, but if I just do one little thing, I'll stand out. But again, for sure, we've just seen over the years, you guys doing research and launching products like crazy on a monthly basis simply doesn't work, you know, in the cloned market. So, okay, what are we looking at over here then?
And this is another cloned market that I found. This is has a low level of search result. It's a log hoop, so it just stores logs. And if you look at this, all the same. Okay, those highly rated ones we can ignore. And if we go in here, we just see it's just a Me Too market. Everyone is trying to stand out. Maybe this one is having a little bit more firewood than this one. Okay, that one packed it a bit differently. This one is from a different view. But for you to come in here and stand out, it's going to be very difficult.
Yeah.
So this for me is very, very cloned. It's just over and over, I would say considerable. And enough so that I would just be like, if I find a market like this, I'll pass. There are a lot better markets to look at to sell in.
Dude, that makes completely sense. Like clone market. This is the kind of advice that's going to help you to really get your investment back as quick as possible. So I think clone, we covered it in detail. The other one I get then is we've got confused. We got cloned. Now, this is a difficult one that I get all the time from people saying, what is a noisy product then? Like it's noisy. The market is noisy. How does that look like? Why is that a problem? What is that?
Yeah. So for us, noisy would be it'll be difficult to stand out. So for noise, we ask ourselves, am I able to compete? Am I able to stand out? Or will my listing stand out? Will it be able to compete in this market? And if the answer is no, then obviously it's a noisy market. So noisy can be anything like visually distracting, or like very big pack sizes, you know, just all over the place. So I have one here that I can look at, food picks. So this one has a bit like higher search results, but so I wouldn't really like to see that amount, but just for this video to explain what noise looks like. If I go in here, it'll be difficult for my listing to stand out. I mean, the people are packing it like in rows, in circles. They have like little bonuses. There's 4 packs, there's 10 packs, there's 50 packs. I mean, these are dogs, little cats, it's just all over the place. You can put a pink unicorn in here and people will not even notice it. I'm sure. There's a blue, what is that? A giraffe. And I mean, I didn't even notice it.
Pink unicorn doesn't stand out, then you're going to have a problem, you know, for sure.
Yeah. So, there we go. There it is. I mean, went looking for it, but it just looks like the same. It just looks
even like a unicorn has been done. I mean, it just goes to show. Okay, so this is noisy. Is there like maybe another one you can show us? Because this is crazy noisy.
So this is already giving me a little chuckle, that little photoshopped ribbon in there.
Yeah.
But yeah, this is kind of, I mean, Everyone is trying to put different things onto this wristband to make it look more attractive to the customer or to the consumer coming in here, but they're all just looking the same. It's really difficult. I can't see myself bringing a product in here and putting my photo in there and looking different. No one's gonna be like, "Ooh, look at that guy. He's selling a magnetic wristband." I mean, you can probably do the opposite and come in here. Like if you want to and just do nothing on stuck onto it, and then maybe you'll stand out. But it's still, I won't, I mean, this is just all over the place.
It's
But
over.
this is obviously also cloned, but definitely very noisy. And then the next one is a bed proofing. So if you look at this is the kind of product that I like to see. I mean, it looks boring, it's just a basket. But when you go into this market, you can, I mean, we can ignore the sponsored products, but
Wow.
there's a basket with a bonus. There's like a little pack. There's like two different ones. This one has something. I mean, this is just all over the place. They, I mean,
It's like all the listings are shouting at me, buy me, buy me. It's like it's like this competition. They're always
exactly.
screaming at me, and I'm just like, whoa, like shut down. It's like, where do you go? Which one do you buy? Like it's almost like it's confused, it's cloned, and it's noisy. All at the same time.
No, this is also definitely confusing, but yeah, the noise is just too much. I mean, my ears are hurting as I'm sitting and looking at like it just, yeah, that's just too much.
Something that I also want to do on this video is to really give people a lot of value, maybe show them a little bit behind the scenes. Let's say you do have a product that you think, you know what, this could be something potentially that I can move forward with. Maybe we can give people like a bit behind the scenes at what MPSH gives people in terms of software, the ecosystem. How does that look like? Because we've got a fantastic tool to help people to make that decision. You know, can you maybe show us behind the scenes there how that looks like?
Yeah, so I think it's this, we called it the root score or the root calculator. And based on all the, you know, different pillars that we look at, we can score a product. So let's just take a product. We're gonna do something like a ping pong cover. Ping pong
Wow.
table cover. I
Interesting.
hope it brings the table up. Yeah, there we go. It's the
Okay.
right one. First of all, when I find a product that's probably viable and I look at this, I mean, it's a cover. So the first thing we usually look at is blandness. So whether it's boring or not, we don't want to sell as seen on TV flashy types of products. We can give it a score rating of 1 to 5 stars. 1 star would be we would say it's a very flashy product, and 5 stars would be a very, very boring product, which we like. We like boring because boring sells. So for this ping pong cover, I mean, it's a rather boring product. I wouldn't say it's the most boring product I've ever seen. So we just call it a roots product. So I score it at 4, saying this is rather boring. Then the next pillar we look at is the search results. Now, obviously, you don't want to see something like 10,000 or 20,000 here. You want a low level of search results for your most generic key term. And this one is 369, which is rather low. So that would score on our root score. Obviously, 5 stars is best. 5 star we would give for like less than 250. So this is between 250 and 500. So I can just score it there. Next, we're going to look at market size. Now here, I just have to tell you a little bit more info at what you want to see. I'm going to ignore the sponsored products when I look at the market size because they are duplicated somewhere else in the market. So I want to get like the true data. So the thing that you can see is we have different product. Well, I have a little extension called DS Amazon Quick View that allows me to see these BSRs. So the BSRs is the best seller rank, and it's just the rank of where it sells in a certain category. And in this case, I'm just looking at these BSRs. So for me, this is something that you learn and you study. In the course, you get taught this as at what the range you're looking at. So for me, in this category, I'd be happy with anything below 50,000. So these guys are really selling well. So all four of these guys are selling well. I'm ignoring this highly rated part, etc. Going in here, 30,000, 40,000, still selling, 39,000, 31,000. These guys are selling. So the market is, for me, it's not small, it's moving to smallish average as I'm reading these BSRs. This one is definitely out of range. This guy's not selling a lot. This one is in range again, out of range. And as I'm going down, I'm seeing, well, those are sponsored, so I'm ignoring them. But these are kind of going out of range and it's just trickling down. Maybe this guy's a bit lucky selling as well. So for me, this market size is, I would say this is a close to an average market. People are selling. I'm happy with it. I mean, any market I'm looking at, if it's that size, I'm rather happy with it. The next one is the sales price. So if I want to come into this marketplace, I want to compete at kind of the same price point here, which is around the 30 to 50 mark. I think there are maybe a couple that's maybe a lot cheaper, but you can see from the prices here, it's about 30 plus, 30 to 50. So then I just click here between 30 and 50. And the offer clarity, this is something we want to gauge of what I need to sell. Is there a clear route to market? Do I know what I want to do? And then we're just going to remove points for certain things. So if I look at the market and there are different flavors and, you know, styles, etc., doing the same thing, I'm going to remove some points for that. So in this market, there are some. I mean, there's a different color. That one has a bit of a branding on it. That one has a little bit of a pink branding on it. And these two are definitely two different styles. So I'll remove one out of the five stars because it's not really clear. A consumer will have to decide between a couple of points. And then the next thing I'm looking at is the price points, whether there are multiple price points. And in this market, I can see there are. I mean, there's $30, there's a $66, and you know, 25 and a 20 and a 38. So there's definitely multiple price points. So that's kind of a negative thing for me. So I'm moving another point. And then the other thing I usually look at is offer types. Now, offer types, they aren't here. It's something that we say is, are people doing pack sizes or bonuses or doing something different? But I mean, this is very straightforward. People are just buying or selling. They're just selling covers and that's it. So there are no real different offer types. So in that case, we're just going to give it a, we just took out two marks for the multiple price points and let's say the styles. So three stars here. Now the level of clones we can look at in this market, let's just go up and scroll down. So, I mean, they look very similar. And based on the product, because of its blandness, it might be prone to clones, just depending on how many people are actually selling this. So if I go down here, I see, well, it's getting a bit cloned for me. I mean, I'm going down and I'm seeing the same thing over and over. You can see there, especially coming in here. I mean, the photo might be a bit different, but there are a lot of people selling here and their photos are looking the same. I mean, even here. So for me, this is moving towards considerably. So I would score this considerable. But again, if I were to say this is average, it's not going to move the needle too much. But this one I'm saying considerable. Market noise is, will it be easy for me to stand out here? And again, if I look at these images, I do believe that I can bring in an offer here with a bonus item that's going to stand out. The only downside to this market would be the amount of clones. So, but for me, it's not a very noisy market. It's kind of easy. I can really see my listing coming in here with something extra at a nice price point standing out. I can compete. So I would score this a 4. And then the gut feeling for me, this will be like, okay, based on other markets I've seen, et cetera, what do I think? Do I think it's a good market? And it's something that when you do a lot of market research, you kind of hone the skill of becoming like a little bit better at choosing, you're having a gut feeling about a market. And for me, I'm pretty much straight down the middle because on the one side, I see there's a lot of clones, but on the other side, it's not really noisy. The price points are rather good. And yeah, as someone doing this whole thing, you saw there when I clicked the last button there, it gave a little percentage here, like a scoring system and a root score of 39. And we like to look at this percentage. And if it's anything 60% and above, we would reach out to suppliers. So this is definitely a rule in for us to move forward with suppliers. But again, just because of the gut feeling, I know I'd really want to give a good offer here because of the amount of clones, but it's something to move forward to with suppliers.
Dude, that is brilliant. And there you have it. You know, for someone coming into this, there's a couple of things you have to avoid, you know, and then a huge thing is having the software and having that tool to help you to move forward, giving you confidence, you know. So Listen, man, I want to thank you so, so, so much. If you guys enjoyed today's video, give it a like, subscribe to the channel. And there is a link, Vian, where people can actually book in and have a chat with me or Justin in our team. And we can help people to get there, you know. So, but I want to thank you so, so much, Vian, for coming up, sharing this with us. And yeah, man, I will see you inside our awesome community, man. Have an awesome day.
Yeah, awesome. Keep researching. Have a good one.